In this video, we are going to be looking at the dry sand tool in the grain shell set. So here we have two objects in our scene. We have the spike, which we're going to drop onto the ball. The spike will be turned into sand using the dry sand tool. The first thing we need to do is turn this ball into a static object. We're also going to need a ground plane to catch all the sand that will fall. Let's turn off visibility on the ground plane. And we're going to select the spike and turn it into dry sand. So here you can see that our spike is now made of sand grain particles, and the particle size is pretty big. The benefit of a bigger particle size is reduced sim time, but we're going to make them smaller. Hit the L key to organize the nodes. We're just going to take a look at the nodal network generated for us, and we're going to look specifically at the grain update node. It's already selected, so let's collapse the pane. And we're going to go to particle separation and type in a value of 0.01. And before we hit playback, for those who have a card that supports OpenCL, we're going to enable Use OpenCL as it will help to significantly reduce the sim time. And we're going to turn on real-time toggle and go back up to object level with the U key. Now we can hit play with the up arrow key and see what we get. Okay, let's stop our playback and take a look at our sand. So you can see that the particles are flying out in all directions, which isn't really what we want. Let's go in the grains update node and change a few parameters. Double-click on the AutoDop network and go to grains update node. It's already selected. We're going to increase the constraint iterations to 60, but be aware that higher values will result in a longer sim time. And now we'll go to the behavior tab and change scale kinetic to 1. And the rest will keep at default. Now go back to frame 1 and hit the U key to go back up to object level. And now we can hit play to see what we get. Let's stop the animation and zoom in for a closer look. So you can see that it's pretty different from the previous cook. We have a bit of a sand pile accumulating on the ball, and also a ring of sand accumulating underneath. Here's a closer look at a pre-cooked sand sim, and you can see the grains falling off the sphere over time. There are many different results you can get by tweaking parameters, so have fun as you explore the possibilities.